Hi, this is Bob from Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff. And if you're looking for an online Toughbook community that gives tips, tricks, and support, hit the subscribe and bell button for all our upcoming videos. In today's video, I'll be giving a walkthrough of positives and a little history of the Panasonic Toughbook CF-H2. So stay tuned. Welcome back, guys. I'd like to start by saying this unit has its strength and weaknesses, but overall was an underrated tablet. It's basically ultra rugged, ultra mobile, ultra powerful. Like its fully rugged laptop family, the Toughbook CF-H2 has vibration resistance and a durable magnesium chassis. Built to withstand a 6-foot drop, and a full military grade faction. It has a laptop grade i5 processor. It even uses the same screen as the CF-19 MK5, which if you haven't known this, was bright by any means as any other rugged computer. I mean, it had a 6,000 nit backlit screen. It's fully rugged, ergonomic. It even sports a digitizer, hot swappable battery ports, so there's two of them. Pop it in the cradle, and it has a cradle, and get plenty of ports to hook up a keyboard and a mouse. Great tablet for mobile use. It comes with a stylus, a touch stylus, and holder for easy access while you're using it on the job. You can control it with just one hand. The perfect tool for field workers, medical professionals, or anyone who needs a tablet they can rely on. It has a hand holder just like this, so you can walk around, and it's lightweight. Extremely rugged. It has this nice port replicator. What I like about this port replicator is it gives you two battery ports in the back, so you can have two batteries charging while you're using it. These batteries in the unit are charging. So the battery ports are here. You put one battery in here, and the unit works just fine with just one battery. You can put the other battery in this side. So once they're all charged up, you have double battery power. The port replicator actually comes with a serial port, a VGA port, three USB ports, and a NIC port. You would plug your power adapter in here, you put your batteries in here to charge. So in essence, you can have hot swappable batteries, four of them, that when these two in the unit wore out, your two that you're charging could be popped in and you wouldn't even miss a beat, you'd still be working. So that's the H2 with its port replicator. The negatives would be the 4 gig limit on RAM and the lousy camera that's on the back. But lots of Toughbooks don't have cameras anyway, so I don't know why you're complaining. It seems like its biggest shortcoming is that Panasonic didn't really know how to market it. It's too different from what people expect in a tablet. I mean, after all, you're looking for that thin, usable tablet. Potential purchasers likely didn't even know what to make of it. It also followed the CF-H1, which by most accounts was an underpowered dud. That H1 really was bad. I believe the H1 was also marketed exclusively to the healthcare industry. I think they tried to broaden the appeal of the H2 by pushing it as a more general field worker computer, but that just didn't clarify what the thing was supposed to be. I don't know. This thing is so underrated. It was also extremely expensive. When it came out, brand spanking new, with a starting price well over $3,000. So you had to be really committed to the idea of the CF-H2 in its bulky condition. And that's it. That's my walkthrough of the Panasonic Toughbook CF-H2. Any questions or comments, please leave them below. Thanks for watching. See you next week.